So I saw this guy doing a tutorial on a pretty awesome transition. The transition is super easy to make itself inside of Premiere Pro. It's a lot harder to figure out how to do it inside of LumaFusion. So I thought, what's better than showing you how to film this effect and how to create it inside of LumaFusion as well. So I'm simply gonna show you some ways, and here I am this is a reveal point. This is something that I will reveal from as a transition from another place. So I'm gonna start by having my camera here, and then I'm gonna move slowly until I reveal the things that I want to film or want to be inside the shot. And the next part is, as I'm going here, I'm going from the wall, and then I'm moving over. And you see this line here, where's my finger here? This one, I'm continuing this movement, like more to the right. And the next shot will be from this one, and I will be revealing this, my kitchen. So once again, I go from here and I move over until I reveal the kitchen. So the next one, which is the starting point, is my office. So here's everything that here's where I create the magic. I'm gonna start by filming this, and then I'm gonna go to the right like this. So that means that this will either be the point where the transition will start, or this. Or it could be this as well. We'll see when we get inside of LumaFusion. And this is how it looks inside of Premiere Pro. And we're gonna try to replicate that effect inside of LumaFusion with the help of green screen. So this is like the second or third time I do green screen inside of LumaFusion. I don't like doing green screen that much, but if it has like a big purpose, like an awesome transition or something like that, I feel like I need to make it. So that's what we're gonna do today. So let's get the iPad and start the tutorial on how you can make this inside of LumaFusion. So once we're inside of LumaFusion and we have our project ready, we're gonna start by importing one of the video clips. So once we imported the first clip, we're gonna start by finding the point where the transition ends and goes over to a new clip, and we're gonna make a cut. Once we made a cut to the clip, we're gonna go and find the position right before we want the transition to start. And then we're gonna go into titles and we're gonna add a new text layer. And as you can see on the right corner, here is where I want the transition to start. So we're gonna go in and add a new text layer exactly at the point where the marker is placed. Then adjust the text layer and make a cut so it matches the end of the main footage. Then we're gonna go into edit on the text layer and we're gonna delete your text here, and then we're gonna add a shape. You can adjust the shape as you want. Then we're gonna change the face color to green, and we move over to frame and fit, and we resize the shape so it covers the entire screen. And the next thing we do is to go to the start of the clip and place the green box where we want it to be, and then make a keyframe. And we're gonna start by moving frame by frame and changing the position of the shape. You can also follow my example to see what I do. Once you're done with all the keyframes, you can go out to your timeline and you can take a look and see how the animation looks. And as you can see, we have the green animation box following the main footage and creating that animation that we want. And the next thing you can do if you want to is go into cropping and you can adjust the edge softness to make the line a little bit more smooth. So once you're done with the cropping, if you want to add that, the next thing we have to do is to render it to our Photos app. Then we go over to our Photos app and we find the newly rendered clip and then we drag it over to our timeline. And now you can simply delete the project that we just created so we only have the rendered file. And make sure to place the render file on the second layer. And we can now go into our Photos app and we can find a new clip. And here you do the exact same thing. You find the position at the beginning of the clip right before the movement starts and then you make a cut and you go to the first rendered file that you made and you find the spot right before you see any green and you make a cut to that clip as well. And the next thing you do is to drag the second imported clip underneath the cutted part of the first clip. And then you go into edit on the first clip and you go to color and effects and you add a green screen luma key. Here you have to play around with the settings to find the best suited settings for you. So the settings that I use might not be the same settings that you need to use in your video. And as you can see, these two clips are not perfectly matched up. So what we need to do here is to go into frame and fit on the second clip. And then go to the start of the clip and make a keyframe and adjust the position. So we're gonna adjust the position by zooming in and rotating this clip. And then we're gonna make a keyframe at the beginning. And we're gonna move to the part where the transition is in center. And then we're gonna move to right before we want the next transition to be and then adjust the position back to its normal size. Keep in mind that this is not something that you have to do if your clip is matched up. This is only something that I had to do for these two clips since they didn't match up properly. So in this last clip, we want the reveal to be at the right side of this line. So we're gonna start by going to the point where we don't see the right side of this line, and then we're gonna add a new shape. And we're simply gonna do the exact same thing. We're gonna go into edit and we're gonna delete your text here, add a shape, make that shape green, and we're gonna add some keyframes so it only follows the right side of that line. So for this part, I'm just gonna speed up the animation and we're gonna go out to the timeline once the animation is done. So here you can see the last animation that we just created. So the next thing we do is to render this to our Photos app as well. And we can now delete the project that we had been working on and we can import the newly rendered file. And we can go into our Photos app and we can add a new clip. And then we're gonna find the position right before we see any green and then we're gonna make a cut. And we're gonna do the same thing, go into color and effects, then add a green screen luma key and key that out. And we have our final result.
So that's how you make this awesome walk by or slide by transition effect in LumaFusion. If you like this video, please consider giving it a big thumbs up. If you didn't like it, thumbs down. And if you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing. It really helps me out a lot. And that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Smash that notification bell and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.